Yo, what's going on, guys? JBH here, and today I'm back on R Factor 2, where we are back in the Gen 2 Formula E car, and we're going to be driving around the Rome E-Prix circuit. Now, my last two outings in the Formula E car, we've had one win and one DNF. Last time out was in Marrakesh, and the AI was pretty difficult to handle, so they seem a little bit easier so far. I've just done a practice session. I'm going to go and do a quick qualifying session now before we get into the race, and yeah, hopefully get back to them winning ways. Okay, so qualifying has been run and done. We have managed to put it on the pole, and by quite a long margin as well. I have got the difficulty set to 120%, which is as high as it will go, but unfortunately, yeah, we are quite a lot quicker than the AI, so I'm expecting hopefully an easy race and an easy win here. All right, AI aggression 40%, damage multiplier is maxed out, so as per usual, we have to try and stay away from these barriers and the AI. Because these cars, although they're pretty indestructible, you know, you don't want to pluck a wheel out of alignment by flicking into a wall or something ridiculous. But yeah, without any further ado, we'll jump onto the grid and get this race underway. All right, back in the Formula E Gen 2 car on R Factor 2 Rome E-Prix. Smash it into first, we're underway. Good start. Side hairpin to begin the lap. This is definitely one of the more fun tracks on the e-calendar. It's quite a long one as well, so I'm trying to remember where I'm going. Oh, that's deep. Yeah, another thing as well is the track has a lot more grip than some of the other track or Formula E track mods on R Factor 2, which is always handy. Noddera, so that gearbox getaway. We are a lot better than the AI through this section. And back up the hill. Try and focus here. These first couple laps are crucial. Try and build a gap. Just control the race. Last time out, I did struggle around the streets of Marrakesh compared to the AI. We didn't quite have as much pace as what we do here. I can totally hear the crowd in the background, no worries. It's realistic. Back through the hairpin. I suck at these hairpins. Oof, that was way too early, but turned it into somewhat of a handbrake turn. I don't know how this tyre is going to wear out throughout the race. The tyre in this FV car is absolutely terrible. I mean, this whole car just has no grip whatsoever. No power, no grip. Oh, that's too deep. Woo. Saved it. Oh, Joseph's driving like a busted ass right now. So busy around here, my gosh, it just never ends. Alright, let's get ahead down. Let's try and get some nice together. That one up. Now, one of the key aspects of the Formula E sort of series is the whole battery saving aspect about it, I guess you could say. Now one of the big key aspects in the Formula E series is the sort of battery saving, the way you got to sort of drive the car. These cars, well, they are battery powered, so you got to try and get them through the race on the energy tank that they start out with. One of the key aspects of the Formula E series is, of course, the whole battery saving process. You have to somewhat perform as a driver. However, I've got the sort of battery set to unlimited, I guess you could say, because the AI are incapable of doing it. You know, whenever I have it set on, they just run out before the end of the race. So we're not doing any of that today, which is good. We get to press on as hard as we can for the entirety of the race. That wall. I just do not get a break, man. I'm going to get blistered by this thing. Maybe he's in a G29. Expect
Inferno.
Lucas. Yeah, 22 minutes is the race distance, so around half of what it is in real life. Try and press on. We are better in that sort of first, I guess, sector compared to the AI. It's through here, we sort of struggle. Honestly feel like I'm driving some sort of rally stage. Oh, that's... no, we've hit the wall. I think we got away with it. Still steering straight for the most part. Woof, that was lucky. Very, very lucky. I actually hit that quite hard. Cars actually are pretty indestructible for the most part. I think in real life that definitely would have been a car. Well, the left rear would be well out of tow right now, but got away with it. With the sort of lap in qualifying, the timer starts as you come out of the pits there, just before you hit this sort of section, but the actual race lap starts on that, well, where the grid is with the hairpin as the first corner. So it's weird, I keep getting sectors all sort of mixed up, but it's been a good start to this lap. Do a gap to go in second. I love Italia. I'd actually visit Rome last year, took the missus there for the 21st. Also, I do love the cities. sadly. All that's happened in Italy hit so much harder than other nations by this virus. Hopefully the country returns to its usual self soon. Out a 3 second gap to the car in second, well, 2.5 seconds. Trying to maintain it now. Consistency is the key. I do like not having to save energy though, as we just drive as fast as you want, don't have to do that whole lift and coast thing. Even though I do actually find it easier driving this car with the whole sort of lift and coast, you know, there's no sort of engine braking in these cars, so it's much easier to sort of coast into the corners than what it is to sort of slam on the brakes straight from the, going from the throttle to the brake, like that. 10 minutes to go, so just over halfway. Man, this race has gone so much longer than what it usually feels like. I'm sweating though. Front end. Whoop, hit the wall again. I said at the beginning you got to avoid the walls, but usually you do, but around here it's not too bad, I don't know why. The fake walls, they're really just pillows. This heat is getting to me, I'm talking shit. That is, but in the UK, you know, you've got so different to being in Australia where I grew up, you sort of have all this heating, so in the winter it's fine. Come summer, you've got no air conditioning, you absolutely sweat your bollocks off, and then Australia in the winter, you've got sort of, well, AC, so usually fine, but it barely ever goes below like 20 degrees anyway. But no, yeah, you've got no way to sort of avoid the heat over here, I've found. So that handbrake turn. No. Every now and then I go that little bit too hot in there. Sorry, because this car's so deceptively slow. Like, you feel like you're going like, well, ridiculously slow, and then you realise how little grip these cars have. Oh, okay. No, what's happened? No! Oh my god, I've got no left rear! No! What's happened? Oh my god, I'm done! I have no left rear tire, what the hell? Okay, well, I seem to rub that wall and just destroy my car. Oh my god. I literally have no left rear tire. I'm done. I'm out.
Oh my god.
Wow. What a monumental dickhead.
Oh, I can't believe I just did that.
I literally just rubbed the wall and something ripped my... Wow. I am one special unit, I tell you what. Thing is, I like nailed the ball so many times throughout that race, and then all of a sudden, just that tap all of a sudden like rips the fucking left rear tire. Oh my god, what a prick.
Anyway, that's the end of that, guys. Yeah, thanks for tuning in. Yeah, on to the next one. I'll catch you guys later.